Hello again, ladies and gentlemen, Sonic Yoda from SEGADriven.com, and welcome back to our Sonic Amateur Games Expo 2020 coverage. In this video, we're taking a look at Sonic Pinball Panic, developed by Orokro. I think that's how you pronounce that. Okay, so Sonic the Hedgehog is no stranger to pinball. We obviously have Sonic Spinball, we have Sonic Pinball Party, we've got the Generations Casino table that you can get with the DLC. There's the Sonic Adventure tables that feature in the Casinopolis. Sonic and Pinball go together like a hand in a glove. But there has never been a real Sonic the Hedgehog pinball table. As in an actual thing that you stand over and, you know, play with a proper steel ball and, yeah, proper pinball. This is obviously not that, but it's trying its best to be that. This is a realistic simulation of a Sonic-themed pinball table built within the restrictions and confines of an actual pinball table, with similar gimmicks like habit rails and ramps and rollovers and drop targets and things like that. And it's a really solid little effort. I'm really, really impressed with this. You get the single table, obviously themed entirely around Sonic. The way it plays is that each stage features a set of Badnik drop targets that you have to obviously hit in their entirety. And once that's done, you can then access Robotnik and hit him to defeat him as the boss. Then it moves you on to the next zone. It's you know, similar structure obviously to an actual Sonic game, which is really, really fun. They've really, you know, thought about the gimmicks that they can bring across and implement them really well. I can't fault it for that, to be honest with you. It's definitely a really well-designed thing that uses gimmicks from the original Sonic the Hedgehog game and turns it into a working pinball table. A working virtual pinball table, because yes, as I say, this is a video game and not the real thing. But there's nothing to say that this couldn't work, you know, as an actual functioning pinball table. I like this as a concept in general. Big fan of pinball personally. I love pinball games. If you've been a fan of this channel for any length of time, then you'll know that we've done a full YouTube series on every single Mega Drive pinball game. So this absolutely ticked the boxes for me. Really, really enjoyed my time with it. The only thing I'd say is that the ball itself feels very light and rubbery, and not like a heavy metal ball. It doesn't really react the way I'd expect it to in a real pinball table. It's very quick and bouncy, and yeah, that's not real pinball. It's fine. It's absolutely playable with those physics, but if you're familiar with how the way actual pinball feels, then this will feel a little fast, a little too, you know, intense. It's a very bouncy, very twitchy game, unfortunately. You can't really play it strategically or with any sort of skill. It's very much just whacking flippers and watching the ball clatter into things. You can obviously direct it pretty well. It's quite a good simulation as far as pinball sims go, to be honest with you. But it's just, yeah, like I say, it's a little bit fast, a little bit bouncy, which is not particularly like real pinball. But otherwise, this is a really fantastic effort. I love the idea of turning the Sonic franchise into a, you know, realistic pinball table instead of the sort of video pinball stuff that we've had before, which, you know, can work without the confines of realistic pinball. But this does that really well. The only thing I'd say about, apart from the physics being a little bit quick and a little bit bouncy, is that there is an area behind the loop here where I got the ball stuck once. But luckily, you can nudge it out and it's not a problem. But just a little bit of a design quirk there that I think needs addressing. But otherwise, really, really good fun. The one other thing I will mention is that it's quite easy. I was draining balls like nobody's business, and yet I still had two left after like ages, and I couldn't quite suss out like how you actually drain a ball, to be honest with you. But when I actively did it, it does take a long time for the ball saver to actually sort of like go away before you can actually drain a ball. So it's a little bit too generous, I think. This needs to be shorter ball saver, basically, would really help this. And for whatever reason, whenever I drained it down the middle between the two flippers, didn't really seem to do anything. I could fire the ball again. It only seemed to ever work if I drained it down the left-hand side, down by the left flipper. And then it would eventually, you know, I would lose a ball. But I was earning extra balls like nobody's business. It's so easy. So, I think this needs to be a little bit more challenging to be a genuinely fun pinball experience. But again, these are all minor complaints, to be honest with you. I think this is a really well-designed table. I really like what they're going for with a realistic sort of pinball table based on the Sonic franchise. And it can only go better from here. I think if they tweak the physics a little bit, make the ball feel a little bit more weighty, less bouncy, and, you know, sort out those small problems I had with, you know, getting the ball caught behind the loop and just it being a little bit too forgiving, you know, I think this would be an absolute essential play, to be honest with you. Great little thing. Really enjoyed my time with it, but it does need a little bit of fine-tuning to be an absolutely brilliant pinball table.